Hello, my Soccer Universe. Finally, something else but Germany and Austria. So we look today, now at least, to other leagues that have already finished their pro programs. They don't have Monday games. And that is the Eredivisie, which we will start with, and then League. We have quite a few things to talk about. I want to, in both leagues, quickly touch on the main transfers that were happening. Although, especially in the Eredivisie, it's really, really hard to judge. We'll talk a little bit about results. We had a really big game in the Netherlands between AZ and PSV, with PSV winning, continuing a great start of theirs, with another game being postponed. So maybe we'll get this time a title race between PSV and Ajax. That would be very, very interesting. And in France, we have to talk about a verdict in Nice, Marseille. Again, a little bit transfers. And then, yeah, we had also quite some interesting results, more concerning the bottom end of the table. We have already a few crisis teams, and some of which were not entirely expected. And we also have quite some interesting developments up top. So let's get started. Here are the results of the Eredivisie before we talk a little bit more about these transfers. I mean, as I said, it's really, really, really hard to judge, because if you go on Transfermarkt, the top two transfers are actually exits, which is Daniel Malen, who was a pretty important player for Eindhoven, going to Dortmund, and then Noah Lang, that surprised me, joined Brügge from Ajax. So that is one huge market value, but honestly, I have not really heard of them, so please fill me in if you know. But there are others that, you know, first exits. I mean, Cope Maynard from Alkmaar is going to Atalanta. That was transfer. Denzel Dumfries going to Inter. Yeah, we have to see. I mean, Inter is a little bit a sinking ship in some ways. And then also Stengs leaving Alkmaar. So another very important pillar of this AZ team going to Nice. I think the biggest and one transfer that I did not see coming, but was already very soon announced, was Steven Berghuis, the Feyenoord captain, going to Ajax. That seems to be one of those transfers where, hey, A, can you do that? And B, is this even fair that you take the captain of Feyenoord and plug him into the arguably best team in the league? And then one that is, I think, a little bit more close to me is that, of course, last captain Kenneth Turner joined Feyenoord. Maybe he will make up for Berghuis. He has definitely the leadership quality, but he's more a defensive guy. As for the results in the Eredivisie, we had, of course, outstanding result, 5-2 Cambuur against Go Ahead Eagles, two promoted teams. Ajax, thanks to a Allaire goal, beat Zwolle. And then the AZ against PSV game. I unfortunately only saw all the goals, but what goals those were. The first one through Pascali in the 14th minute, a screamer from far out. I mean, if go and watch any highlights that you can find. Second goal through Vertessen was one where AZ was completely caught in transition. And then the third goal again from far out from Doan in the 83rd. Another really, really nice attacking goal. I have a feeling a PSV might go places in the Eredivisie. Despite all the people they have lost, they seem to be a machine at the moment. And this is down largely, I would say, to the coach Roger Schmidt, who, well, once his system gets rolling, see Salzburg, he can be really, really, really dangerous. I do not know why Feyenoord against Heracles was postponed to the 1st of December, but let's see. Which means that on top we have still PSV and Ajax riding high, and for all the rest, you know, adjusting and expected standings and so on, and the upcoming games, I'll show it to you towards the end of the video. So let's go straight to League. First off, the OGC Nice OM game has been voided. We had bans given to the assistant coach of Marseille, who actually started a fist fight, and also one game ban. What's his name now? I wanted to Dimitri Payet. Nice has to play, I think, two more games behind closed door, one of which is the replay of this game on a neutral site, and the game will be replayed, so the game was completely voided. This was to me a little bit so surprising. And in addition, Nice has been deducted 2 points, of which one is just a suspended point, which means in the standing, Nice falls a point behind Marseille immediately before that. So this was the immediate impact, but both teams really enjoying a good start. Second, let's talk transfers before we go into the happenings of the weekend. I mean, what can I say about Liga? The top transfers at PSG is the winner for me of the entire transfer window. You get Messi, you get Hakimi, you get Donnarumma, you get Sergio Ramos, you get Wijnaldum. I mean, all the big transfers this season, they're all incoming transfers, went to PSG, making PSG the new Galacticos in many ways. However, I have to say there are other interesting ones. For instance, two losses for the league in Eduardo Camavinga, who went to Real Madrid, kind of saving Real Madrid's transfer window a little bit. And Memphis Depay, of course, going to Barcelona and maybe saving face for the Catalans, given his great form there. Another one that concerns me is Mike Maignan going to Milan. However, I want to talk about OM, who actually had some quite interesting incoming players. I mean, Gerson from Flamengo could be an interesting player coming up. They got now Milik for sure, they got Cengiz Ünder, and they also got Matteo Guendouzi, who is always this so-and-so player. I think those are all really, really interesting players that could maybe pay some dividends. Marseille already enjoying a pretty good start. As for the results of this weekend, I mean, I really only saw highlights of the Friday and Saturday game, but I'll mention at least the implications of the other games. Lorient beating Lille. Lille still not getting going. I mean, the first goal by Lorient through Lorient. Where it's very confusing when you hear. I mean, that's a goal where five players cannot bring down, I think it was Hoffi, and Moffi, and then the ball goes to Lorient, who can slam from a short distance. Yilmaz can equalize, and then Lille is actually pressuring for the win, and I caught on a counter where Moffi then gets the winner in the 87th minute. Lille really having a bad start to the season and falling in the standings. Speaking of, not bad starts, good starts, we have to say. PSG continued their winning form against Clermont-Foot. There was no Messi and Neymar and so on, because they all were still caught in South America. So André Herrera steps up with the 2-2 goals in the first half. Mbappé adds one, and then I think he even assists kind of the Idrissa Gueye goal to make it 4-0. So Clermont-Foot for the first time beaten, and to be honest, PSG really looking to be the class of the league. More worryingly though, is the big one in France between Monaco and Marseille, where OM completely dominated Monaco. Monaco is having a horrible start to the season, and I could very well see Coach Kovac being out very, very soon. You didn't make it into the Champions League, although you should have. You have a pretty excellent squad, and you played very well last season. But the 2-0 was flattering. Dieng, I think, hit twice the post. And this Marseille team, I think there might be something growing. We might, not this season. I think this season Marseille could qualify for the Champions League if they keep things up as they do. But, you know, Dieng scoring two goals, and I think he even twice hit the post. So very, very impressive from the Marseille. Now, to other results, teams in trouble. I mean, Montpellier Saint-Étienne doesn't sound as exciting, but I have to say Saint-Étienne is a team that has been in trouble for quite a while. Bordeaux is in serious amount of trouble. And that Vladimir Petkovic took this suicide mission is really beyond me. Bordeaux is a team seriously, seriously in trouble. We also have Nice getting another win, so they continue to start. Metz losing to Troyes, maybe Troyes getting, finding the footing in the league. And Lyon, who also, there's another transfer I didn't mention, they got Jerome Boateng, maybe solidifying them back 3-1 over Strasbourg. So I think Lyon maybe is a big one. Very important, next weekend we have PSG Lyon, and that might be the home debut of Messi. In the standings at the moment, PSG is still up there. Angers, still second spot, and then Marseille and Nice. I think Marseille and Nice might have a saying. I think, at least at this very moment, I do like these two teams quite some, although Nice a little bit hampered by now by the point taking off and so on. Lyon, if they can get it going, I think they will go in there. And if you look at the bottom of the table, we have Saint-Étienne and Bordeaux, two big name teams in France that are very, very much on the bottom, especially for Bordeaux. It looks really, 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 really bad. Lille also, only midfield. Monaco, close to the relegation. I know it is early, but it doesn't look pretty. And so, yes, I will leave you now with all the stats and standings, expected, adjusted, and so on, for these two leagues right here. Leave a comment below on the happenings that from these two leagues in the comments below. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos like these, and I will talk to you soon. Bye. Hey there, I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, here are some videos and playlists that you actually might enjoy too. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel and click that little bell, so in order to stay updated whenever something happens in my soccer universe. With that, have a good day.